Indonesia Buddhist student. I want to ask, because alright, the panel already talked about the past and the future probably do, but I want to ask what we should do now. Yeah, because I think other things we must collect the phone and burn it along, so we don't need to call in to have electricity and the others. Or maybe we need to think about how we make a good electricity, cheaper, higher, but good. I need, if I come back to Jakarta and talk it to my friend, and then we become stressed. Oh, I need to thinking about how to make it cheaper. Oh no, I have the other job gain, right? So what we should do now? Because I think we are conference here. I think we need something to take to our country, something to take to talk to our friends, our parents, or the other. What we should do now to make sustainability is possible. Thank you. Do you have a...
Thank you for your question. Well, I think Dr. Amanda gave the most concrete suggestion possible about behaviors, right? So what we can change within the same day is our own behaviors. And Dr. Amanda gave actually a very clear step-by-step how to change that about our consumer choices. And that can be expanded into to very, very easy, very common things, like switching off the lights and saving water, making that a part of our identity. Behavior change comes first, identity change comes next as a result of that. So when you ask what to do now, you make sustainability a part of yourself through your actions, and that can start at any point. What's that?
I focused on that because that's something that's common to all of us, right? Everyone sitting in the room can take day-to-day action, right? But I actually agree with a point that Henry made, which is that our individual actions aren't enough. There's a lot of other changes that need to be made, right? We have to, there's things that are happening with big business, there's things that are happening with our governments, there's a lot of things that have to be changed. So in terms of what we do next, I think the main thing is it's not one thing. Right? We all have to be working on different areas simultaneously, and it's all of that push, all in the same direction, that will make things move forward. So then it becomes about asking yourself, what's a good fit for me? Right? What's my right livelihood? Right? You have to think what your experiences, what your skills are, and what your passions are. And maybe some people decide they're going to focus on the renewable energy side, how to make the technology cheaper, and other people are going to campaign and try and get the government policy to change. And it's all of us doing that that starts to move things forward, right? It's all of us thinking what's best for us to do to make the whole bigger movement go forward.
So actually, in Taiwan, I would like to share with you the experiences led by Ciji, a Buddhist Compassionate Organization. Some of the people here may be also familiar with Ciji.
我为什么要谈这个个案呢？因为他是有一个团体的力量的鼓励，也就是说，慈济人呢，在正言法师的领导下，他们的生活极度的简朴，甚至于整个正言法师的精神呢，在他自己的会客室是完全不用冷气的。So
actually, even the leading bhikkhuni, Venerable Zhen Yan herself, in her own VIP reception room, there is no air conditioning, and then this very, very large foundation uses a joint effort by all the members to promote a very simple way of life that consumes responsibly. Okay, so actually once she noticed that in the marketplace there were different kinds of garbage and waste, and then she told all her members and followers that with both the funds that you applaud for me, please do start doing the recycling. And within very short time, thousands and millions of members and followers started doing recycling. As a result, in Taiwan, it was it became a movement that everybody started doing recycling. Now we are very successful in terms of recycling, reusing, and actually we reduce all the wastes.
那在这个情况之下，他们严格的在社区去劝导资源回收的分类。后来台湾呢，就整个政府才开始实行，可以说是民间团体、佛教民间团体先走，政府在后面，终于全面的资源回收。
So besides the members, actually they also went into different communities and start teaching or helping, encouraging all the residents in those communities to classify all their household waste, so that it became a very, very forceful driving force that moved or actually that really urged the government to start a government policy and action to do recycling throughout the whole Taiwan. So this is a very good example of how individuals can really help push for that movement.
而且那个运动后来的成功是他们的许许多多的资源回收分类呢，经过了整理以后，所有的那些保特瓶的那些颗粒呢，他们重新制造成为救灾的毛毯。 他们运用最高的科技，就像刚才巴西就先生说的，用高科技呢，把它回收制作成毛毯，全球的国际赈灾都是经常他们是整批整批整船整船的送出去给这个有灾区的灾民，让他们有温暖的毛衣，有温暖的毛毯可以度过寒冬。
So actually, as what our friend from Brazil has shared, Tsuji Foundation recycle all those bottles, and then they use the help of high tech to turn all these recycled items into blankets, sweaters, which they send out with all kinds of cargoes and containers throughout the whole world to help with the disaster victims.
更重要的是，这些人受到了疗愈，因为这些人呢，经常很多资源回收的人，其实包括从博士、从企业家到很多社会底层的人，特别是社会底层人，在这边有了一个团体的力量支持。 正言法师告诉他们，你们不是拾荒者，你们是地球的守护者。因此，他们的生命得到尊严，而且他们在团体中受到了鼓励。很多精神病患、精神分裂者，或者是一些包括一个驼背九十度人，因为一直不断的踩保特瓶，竟然站直了。所以，许多的奇迹在他们那边发生，而且是非常温馨的故事。Okay,
so and then I would also like to share with you, as a result of these joint recycling efforts, those people who are used to be called, you know, the people at the bottom of the society, the scavengers, with very low self-esteem, turned out to develop this kind of very strong self-esteem because all the doctors or entrepreneurs joined them in recycling because Venerable Zhenyuan told them that you are not the scavengers, you are the guardians of the earth. And then, a very, very specific example she just shared with now is a very old man. Because he did a recycling and he had to stand on the bottles, and then with the hood, actually it became a she. So she was able to stand straight right after all the recycling efforts. So they give those people a very strong sense of self-esteem, and also a lot of miracles happened due to these joint efforts.
Thank you very much. Now, the organizers have told me to finish this session at 12, which is just now. So I'd like to end the session. If you have questions, please individually ask the speakers later on, maybe at lunchtime. Well, thank you very much, the speakers. Thank you.
Thank you very much, our moderator, Reverend Masazumi Okano. Now we would like to invite the most venerable Lama Lobsang, he's the founder of the International Buddhist Confederation, to give a gift. May I ask you guys to stay back because we have two announcements. So we would like to invite venerable Lama Lobsang to present the gift. Please give a round of applause to all of the panelists and moderators.
From Taiwan.
you very much, everyone. Thank you, Venerable Lama Lobsang. And okay, the first announcement is that as today is the full moon, there will be a lot of the devotees who will be coming to the temple, maybe 100 or more. So be mindful during lunch, okay? There will be quite a number of people. And second thing, our brother Wong Chun Tat will be waiting for you in the canteen if you have not submitted your departure time and date, okay? And if you are not